really good to see everyone. Thank you for being here. It's kind of hard to believe back into the swing of things with training camp. I think it was a typical first day. A lot of things to build upon. We were able to two-spot a lot of the periods, which in the past we've never had that flexibility nor that luxury to be able to do. But with that, it can become very sloppy. I thought we were sloppy at times. You know, the throwing, the catching, when we got a little winded, a little tired. You know, again, our body positions, we weren't in position to make plays. We dropped footballs. But a lot of things to build upon. Now it's what do we take the information that we gained from practice? We're starting to put all of our football identity on video. And then how can we go in and correct it? And the meetings are just as important, the mental part, as it is from a practice standpoint. It's interesting to see the guys that have been raised in our program and the guys that have transferred in that have never been through one of these training camp practices. And so we got to get them caught up. We got to get the freshmen caught up. But I like our team. I like our expectations now. We just got to get a little bit better each and every day. The other thing I'd like to take this opportunity and really, really thank our entire community. You know, probably extremely vital, as if anything, with the success of our football program is Friday's kickoff party at the embassy. We've asked all of our loyal friends and loyal vendors to come out and support our program, buy a table, buy individual tickets, and it's going to be the first time in the history of our football program that it's been sold out. We're going to have over 600 members from the community, and we're grateful and thankful. All the proceeds go to the Impact Club, and we need it to survive. We need it just to give ourselves an opportunity. So for everyone that has purchased a table, and we're really looking forward to Friday, we have great live auction items, great silent auction items, and we talk about the community involvement. They've been really, really outstanding, and I really appreciate everyone for their loyal support.
What's the biggest objective over these 25 practices until you kick it off against UC?
Yeah, there's a lot of things, but I think the biggest thing is individual growth and development by each player. And whether it's offense, defense, and special teams, make no mistake about it, it's our style of play. You can have the greatest summer going, which I thought we had a very productive summer, but you can never really mimic being in football condition. And when you come out here, you have to play football to get in football shape. And then we haven't even put the pads on or anything, and then you add another physicality to the sport, and it takes on a whole nother dynamic. So I think our style of play, just the fundamental and details and the understanding situation of football, as we talked about it all off season, critical downs, critical down execution. We weren't good on either side of the ball in third and short situations, fourth and short situations, managing those red area. So from a situational standpoint, so it's all broken in different elements of really being a good football player and a good football team.
And just talking about the quarterbacks, your initial impressions of Timmy so far?
Yeah, I've liked Timmy. I've liked Timmy from day one, and I think Jalen and him have done a really good job. That whole quarterback room, Josh Flowers, they really bonded and they push each other, but they're coaching each other. But you know, Timmy has very, very strong talent in terms of throwing the ball, can run the ball. Now it's just mental, it's the leadership, it's growing into being here. But I've been very pleased with all of our quarterbacks.
Coach, a year ago, day one of fall camp versus this year, day one, what is the biggest difference you feel like in the two?
Yeah, good question. I kind of went back and looked at my notes. I think, first of all, the ability to two-spot. So what two-spot is, you basically have two practices at times going on at the same time. And we didn't have the numbers. We didn't have, you know, different positions. We were short. So now to be able to do that, and you learn through repetition. So instead of them gaining mental repetitions, they're gaining physical repetitions. So it lets us know who's ready, who's not ready, who do we need to invest in. And it's a way for everyone to, again, put their identity on video and improve from that. But I would say the biggest thing is the ability to two-spot. I think we have more leadership, although I'm going to challenge them at times when it got difficult. I thought we had some challenging situations from a weather standpoint, which is good. But I think the biggest thing is our players know our expectation and our standard. And I want to say it's their expectation and their standard. So I've really liked so far report day, and I'll know a little bit more. First 2 days, really you're in helmets, so it's really about conditioning and fundamental details. I'll know more when the pads go on. Every single day we'll learn a little bit more about our personality as a football team.
How much greater is the competitive depth now than even it was at the end of spring with new transfers, yeah, the freshmen who weren't here?
Well, you hit it, and that's why we're able to two-spot is the competitive depth. We're still not there in all nine position groups, but we're getting closer. You know, you look at the defensive end position, that should be one of the most competitive positions we have in all of training camp. I still say, you know, we're not where we need to be in terms of competitive depth in the offensive line. We got numbers, but we need individuals to step up and take advantage of their repetition. Same thing at the receiver position.
Obviously, with the running back room, you have four guys that can contribute. What do you make of just that depth there with the running backs?
First of all, they have character and they have competitive character, and they feed off of each other. They hold each other to a high standard, and it's great to see. And then I think within that room, they each have a unique and different skill set. And so we have to do a good job of coaches of really playing to their skill sets. And they all have a different personality, but you know, they've done a really good job. We talk about power of the position, and they've been able to do that.
You know, you got some competition across the board, position battles across the board. Your first look at the kicking competition, just what you thought?
Ongoing. You know, there was some elements today from kicking on the grass to the different wind swirls and being able to understand how to kick in the wind. So I think, you know, that's going to be ongoing. I know they've worked really hard, but as you know, what makes a great kicker is consistency. And so we'll continue to evaluate every rep as training camp moves forward.